school mascot at some time. Plan recommended the following significant projects. One, the expansion of the water treatment plant. Two, the expansion of rehabilitation of 1344 treatment plant. And three, the rehabilitation of the wastewater, Wisconsin wastewater treatment plant. In 2006, in account of authorizing following professional contracts, one three project, senior, and Wisconsin project, MACAD many. One three became priority as it was out of capacity at the time, and CDM established a rush schedule to move that expansion project forward. In addition, one three was also having numerous overflow in its system. It was constant, it was continuously violating its permit because of capacity issues. So that became priority. Subsequently, the city worked on both firms identified soon necessary funding for the critical work of all the Wisconsin three plants. The city executed a deep loan agreement in amount of $24,97,000 on December 5th, 2007. City obtained a loan to complete the following critical work. A new 30-inch transmission main, the Savannah Pride elevated storage tank, water and sewer services, and entirely rehabilitation of the Wisconsin plant and pool pump station, and various other small projects. In July 2008, Mayor and Council authorized contract MACAD many for engineering, construction, management, and project management services to complete the following improvements to the inform pump station at the Wisconsin plant. Replacement of bar screens and associated electrical equipment and controls, ventilation and air handling systems, accessibility improvements to the pump station structure, and miscellaneous additional repairs. The design work was completed, equipment purchased, and scheduled installation in August 2009. Total value of that project was $2,712,303. As you are all aware, flood occurred on Palm Sunday weekend in April 2009. As such, all pump station improvements had to cease due to the immediate initiation of post-flood FEMA claim process. In 2010, CDM completed two critical reports as follows: the sanitary sewer condition assessment and rehabilitation program plan, and the sewer system modeling and capacity evaluation report. These two plans set forth a detailed analysis of the conditions of all segments of the city's sanitary sewer system outside of two treatment facilities, and set forth a 30-year capital improvement plan for the system. That $192 million capital improvement plan serves as the basis of proposed rehabilitation related to the sanitary sewer system. The CIP does not list the relocation of the Wisconsin plant due to the ongoing FEMA claim process at that time. A little bit of the FEMA claim process, this is all we've talked about this at some time. The assessed level of damage to the Wisconsin plant in 2009 was seen and sustained and retained in federal disaster declaration by the president. And on June 23rd, 2009, CDM was selected by the Mayor and Council to serve as the project manager to prepare the necessary project work sheets for the relocation of the plant. It was determined earlier in the process that the plant could not be repaired as provided by Lowndes County Unified Land Development Code due to the fact that the plant is located in a specialized flood hazard area is defined as a land covered by floodwaters of a base flood on the National Flood Insurance Program maps. The Unified Land Development Code Section 3.01.04, B-3, prohibits the reconstruction of any provision facility in the specialized flood hazard area. City received on August 2nd, 2010, a letter from the county engineer, Michael Fletcher, stating that according to the CDM study of the Wisconsin plant, a large portion of the current treatment plant is located at or below the 100-year flood line. The project was submitted to FEMA in 2009 in the amount of $33 million for a concrete dike surrounding all of the plants that was flooded earlier in the year. And we were never notified of any denial in writing as required by the FEMA